My name is Sandy Simpson. I'm a social studies teacher at Dorchester High School. Dorchester High School is in Codman Square in Boston. We have about 1,000 students. 92% of those students qualify for free lunch. That means they live below the poverty level. Some consider Dorchester High one of the worst schools in the system. I went into teaching to teach at a school like Dorchester High. I am committed to public service and to being an adult that Dorchester students can depend on. But this year, teaching has been like entering a battlefield. I see the realities of poverty every day. Poverty's winning. It's killing our kids, and I'm watching. So this year I wanted to quit. The pull of the streets had sucked in my school and the forces of poverty has battered down our barriers. I fear for my kids and now I am afraid at work. I want to give up and I want to give in. But I am a facing history teacher. I am both burdened by the truth of history and enlightened with the resources and support to teach the lessons of that same history. Facing history keeps me honest. It keeps me focused on the issues that face these kids. Facing history has helped me shape my moral guideposts as a classroom teacher in an urban high school, and with the support I've received from facing history in my classroom, I'm able to teach a rigorous academic curriculum that deals with issues of fear, hatred, ostracism, war, and the choices that we all face. For example, by utilizing the Facing History online campus, Deb Chad helped me walk my kids through an online discussion on ostracism. This activity provided my students a chance to participate in a monitored discussion with teenagers from all over the world. That day in my lab of 25 computers, 6 worked. I expected my 33 itchy 10th graders to climb the wall. But silence ruled as 33 kids gathered around 6 computers, read silently, and took turns responding. This unit moved many of my students, but Tim is who I most clearly remember. Tim's a 16-year-old white student, one of 4 in the school that year. He was on the edge, and I knew we might lose him soon. Tim began bringing his boys into the lab at lunch. He showed them the site. I read their responses and watched as they came back before and after school for days. These boys were involved in a deep discussion about ostracism. This is the work of Facing History in my classroom. Through Facing History, I've been able to explore with my kids the thousands of ways to participate in democracy, in their place of work, and in their relationships. Facing History program associates brave my madness and help me guide our kids through some of the most difficult lessons you can imagine. Facing History can't change the conditions in which my kids live, but they continually push me past my doubts so I can teach my kids about power and choices. My heroes are my kids. You see, the only reason I know these kids is because they've made a difficult choice. They've walked up Peacevale Avenue and into the doors of Dorchester High. Life is very dangerous for these teenagers. With students this smart and this brave, they deserve nothing less than facing history and ourselves.